a white boy on my roster. He be feeding me pasta and lobster. He just hit me up on Tuesday, like, what's doing, babe? Let me take you shopping. I told him, well, I'm a little busy. He said, damn, I'm in your city. But anyway, it's okay, hope you have a good day. I'ma see you by day 50. Then I told him, you treat me so well. He said, can't shop for sale. Matter of fact, scratch that, I'ma see what's that. Just cause you're fine as hell.
That his place is no longer available. He cancelled it upfrontly from his side, but upon cancelling the reservation, he has to pay the penalties, okay, to Airbnb. And second thing, his calendar dates is also blocked. Whatever the trouble the guest has to go through, the host has to go through with the same trouble, because he will not get the any further more reservations for these dates, because it's been affecting on your stay, and it has affected very badly. I absolutely understand, Ms. Shanice.
Well, I'm struggling to understand, like, and I do understand, I do appreciate, like, this isn't your fault. And I don't mean for it to sound like my frustration is on you. But obviously, of course, I've got the event, as you know, in 4 days. I've got students that, like I said, have obviously made commitments. And, like, obviously, for me, this is my reputation. And I generally value my students. I generally value my customers. So I do not want to let, I don't let people down. I don't do any of that unless, like, I was severely in a bad way and I physically couldn't under, like, emergency circumstances. So I get that I'm getting the refund, but of course I would be getting the refund because I didn't cancel the property and I'm not attending it. So I know I'm going to get the refund. So what I'm trying to understand is, where is my compensation for this inconvenience, like, towards, like, I wouldn't even say to help to rectify, because it's not going to rectify anything, but, you know, as a apology and for the inconvenience.
If you want, I can issue you a coupon of $100, like, in future, if you would like to make any reservations through Airbnb.
But obviously, as you can imagine, my experience, like, obviously from Airbnb currently, I don't feel like I have that, like, that brand trust with you guys, because I can't get my refund instantly to go and book another property. Like, I've been let down last minute. Like, it's not just something I can just brush under the carpet. Like, it's a lot of money. I'm gonna either have to cancel my event, or I'm gonna have to use more money to go and get another venue that is not gonna be the same criteria that obviously I booked for. Having $100 on the account for Airbnb to book another property to possibly have the same thing happen again, because you can't guarantee that it won't happen.
Hello.
Hiya, is this Nicholas?
Yes, this is.
Hiya, I've literally just made a booking via booking.com for your property on the 26th of April. I just wanted to confirm, and basically my situation is, I had a mansion hired out for the 26th of April, but unfortunately, the host has cancelled, like, last minute.
All okay with me.
Yep.
I'm just in a meeting.
Oh, okay, no worries.
May I call you back on this number shortly? I will call you back as soon as I am able to confirm everything, okay? It will be in the next 2 hours. Okay, I'll call you shortly.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, bye-bye.
Thanks, bye. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It is Shanshan, a la Shan, whatever you want to call me. And today I'm bringing you guys with me to my first student sleepover. I am so excited for this sleepover because I've never seen anyone do this in the UK, in Holland, in America, like nowhere. So yeah, I'm so excited. I've got so much planned. Like, the car is literally jam-packed full of stuff, and I feel like I've of course probably forgot stuff. I also have some of the girls bringing stuff as well, so yeah, like, it's gonna be a hectic day, but I feel like I'm just so excited. Like, I've been planning for this and I've been envisioning it for like a while, so yeah, I'm gonna bring it to life. I'm gonna take you guys with me because I actually do need to go get my hair done. I do need to go Costco. I do need to go get some stuff for the vision boards. Oh no, I've got a lot to do. So yeah guys, come with me, and yeah, I'm not gonna lie to you, I was meant to film when I went to collect my prints, but I actually got a phone call, so I was sitting inside, but he see me outside, because he must have been with like another customer or a neighbor or something. So he brought me out the magazines and the certificates. So these are the magazines. I will give like a better like vision of them. And then these are the certificates. These are going with the trophies, because they obviously won an award. So that will be at the award ceremony. But I've literally taken a lot longer than I should have. I'm literally going in to try and get a hair appointment now. Wish me luck, because I haven't booked an appointment. Like, I haven't booked an appointment, so I'm literally just praying that they're gonna fit me in. So yeah guys, I will keep you guys updated. Hey guys, so little update. I went to my hairdressers. They couldn't fit me in. You know what? I wasn't really shocked, because they always fit me in like last minute. Like, I just walk in there and I always know like I should really like book a appointment, and I don't. And I just turn up there and they'll always be good like and fit me in. But they've actually got like an event going on. I managed to find another salon like local, so I'm just gonna pray like that's good. I'm literally in Costco right now in the queue. Didn't get everything that I needed. But I did also go to Poundland before I left, before I come here, should I say, and I got like a few little bits that I needed. But after I've got my hair done, I'll go and get the last bits, and then I'll make my way. But yeah, that's basically it, guys. Is so crazy, because when I done my first ever launch party, this is where it was. It was on this road, Whitehall Road. So guys, I am here. I have made it. I just feel very overwhelmed right now, because a lot has happened this week. Like, a lot has happened, and it's so hard doing an event and you are organizing everything, and on top of that, things are going wrong and people are cancelling. And I was so upset, like, at the beginning. I had this idea a while ago, like on the motorway, and I have brought it to life. I am very extra, so I do like to, you know, go overboard and like make sure like I over deliver. But it's been a stressful week, like I can't lie. Like don't get me wrong, like I always done events and they are stressful, and you know, things do happen, like people do cancel, and you know, things do get delayed and things like that, or you don't get like everything in time. But where I've been so busy this week, like I had like such an amazing achievement like on Wednesday, that I had to travel all the way to like near Manchester. But then in the midst of that, like on the way, I had to collect like the prints for my menu cards and my invitations and my itinerary cards that I've got designed for this event. But then prior to that, 3 days before, I was shooting. And then on top of that, I'm working on other projects behind the scenes that obviously have deadlines, and you know, I need to go over them. Like, it's just been a lot for me to sort of juggle, especially where like I have to have that balance where I am doing my washing and paying my bills and keeping up with stock and sending out orders. Like, my day-to-day work doesn't stop. Yeah, it's been very stressful. Even the venue that we was meant to originally have cancelled on Sunday, and I was in the middle of a shoot when I found out, and I had to find another venue. And then like obviously I was meant to be getting like decor done, that got cancelled. And then the prints, like there was a bit of a delay with, so I had to go and collect like the rest of everything today, which you guys saw. I just didn't have time to do everything I wanted, but like I'm so grateful that I've been able to do like everything that I've wanted, and it's finally happened. I have found a beautiful like alternative for the venue, which is absolutely amazing. But again, this is literally like the life of an entrepreneur. Like, these things do happen, and I am a really understanding person, but you know, it just adds that pressure, it adds that stress, and it just does make you question things and like doubt yourself as a like business owner, as an entrepreneur or whatever. But yeah, we are here. Oh, I'm so happy I finally made it.
He want the stoop, she want the tea, she want the tea. I cannot speak, we keep it in street, we keep it in street. I took a loss, but you still gon' get beat, you still gon' fit. How much it costs? It never been cheap, it never been. Turn your click up, dog. Turn them up, turn your bitch up, dog. Turn them up, turn these streets can't cross it. Cross them up, all these streets need bosses. Boss them up, turn your click up, dog. Turn them up, turn your bitch up, dog. Turn them up, turn these streets can't cross it. Cross them up, all these streets need bosses. When my dog get low in his pockets, I'm picking no more. We came from the bottom together, my nigga, we get it, we splitting it up. If my bitch tell me pay for that pussy, I take her ass shopping and tell her shut up. Standing on bitches, ain't nothing to pipe that shit up. It ain't nothing to turn a bitch up. It ain't nothing to turn your click up. Ain't nothing, shit. We turn a jeweler up, just look at the diamonds we bust. Look at the people we touch, shit. I'm feeling like Puffy and Russ. I'm sending this shit like a toilet, little nigga so nasty, I never been flushed. Bullet for Ravens and came with a kid on it. The suit too light, it can't get me spin on it. Hundreds of bands, I put a little shit on it. Dope in my hand, I had to go flip on it. He want the scoop, she want the tea. I cannot speak, we keep it in street, we keep it in street. I took a loss, but you still gon' get beat, you still gon' get paid. How much it costs? It never been cheap, it never been. Turn your click up, dog. Turn them up, turn your bitch up, dog. Turn them up, tiny streets can't cross it. Cross them up, all these streets need bosses. Cross them up, turn your click up, dog. Turn them up, turn your bitch up, dog. Turn them up, tiny streets can't cross it. Cross them up, all these streets need bosses.
Okay. I know that's right. So guys, me and Candice have got some flowers. We're now gonna surprise Sham. Let's go. Let's go. Sham. Okay. So guys, we're now gonna surprise Sham. Let's go.
We love you so much.
Yeah.
She doesn't even know that we've got the camera.
We love you!
Why did you know?
when the camera went missing, I was like, oh fuck.
You beat it out. You know what happened, yeah? I was thinking, no, like, because the way that people asked me, like, why are you following me?
Exactly. Why is she following me everywhere I'm going? Why are you following me? This girl said, yeah, because I need to make sure you're doing things right. I said, excuse me, you don't know what I'm doing right now.
No, I'm so dead.
And you know, I'm 2 on point.
Thank you, girl.
We love you. Look at Candice in her element.
Welcome. This bit is a bit annoying because there's not enough space for it to fit all
and
in.
And then in here.
Yep, there we go.
Her.
Okay. Right.
Okay, Is this what's going on?
Is this what's going on?
Okay. Okay. Pineapples, because if you don't eat them, they're more.
Because
he stinks. Okay, guys. We gotta go upstairs now. We gotta go upstairs now. Wait, everyone get their bags. Everyone get their bags.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
This is my This is what's up.
So we got the tweezers. We got
Who did that? Who did that? Who did that?
We got the hairband. Oh.
No. Okay, then this is your room.
We love you.
I love you.
We love you.
And then this is your room. You can pick whatever bow, because basically the bows basically are coming in like black or cream.
Okay, okay.
So you got options.
It wasn't even her.
Oh, false alarm.
False alarm. It's a delivery.
Jeez, how big is the delivery?
And he said, what, at the front right there?
Yeah. Is this yours or his?
No, his. Maybe not. Start again.
You're like,
Carol, where are you running? Why are you running, Carol? Why are you running?
For the last one, right? Don't worry, you didn't miss much. We were setting up, I was getting everyone to help me. Hello!
Hey!
I'm so nervous.
Sorry, we were standing here like.
I'm like, cameras, everyone. How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
All eyes on you.
Hi!
Boy on my roster, he be feeding me pasta and lobster. He just hit me up on Tuesday, like, what's doing, babe? Let me take you shopping. I told him, well, I'm a little busy. He said, damn, I'm in your city. But anyway, it's okay, hope you have a good day. I'ma see you by day 50. Then I told him, you treat me so well. He said, cash out for sale. Matter of fact, scratch that, I'ma see what's that, just cause you fine as hell.
So, guys, welcome to our
home
ceremony. So I feel like I had this vision of like doing like an eyelash shine student sleepover, and I feel like I wanted to start it off like smaller, just because obviously I've never done it before, and as we have all experienced, things go wrong. But obviously we're here, we've made it, and I'm happy. And now I'm gonna present everyone's awards. So I'm actually just gonna, whatever certificate's on top, I'm just gonna do that one and just go from there. Okay, so this award is for ILS Achievement Over Adversity, and I have chosen this person to win this award because I just feel like, for me personally, like this is such a special category for me, because I feel like this was like my first ever award I won, and I just feel like I know what choosing to win over, like, you know, trials and tribulations in your life, or like whether, like, you know, things are like thrown in your path to sort of like push you away from your like direction. And yeah, I just feel like you've displayed that over and over again since you've come on to the balls, like the relationship with Bill. You've always tried to push your business, and you've always tried to push your like skill in growing like yourself. So this award goes to I'm so so grateful that you chose me as your Lash trainer. I feel like you're such an amazing person, and you really like being transparent and honest like to me about like certain things, and you are such an amazing person, and you are doing so well and so amazing. And honestly, like your future, like I can just see you doing amazing things. And I'm so excited for you.
Oh my gosh, honestly, I have no words. Like, you say you feel lucky. I'm so lucky to even come across you. If it wasn't for my Lash set, so get into Lashes. Because your Lash set would put you on. Like, honestly, I feel so lucky that you even invited me to be around. I always told Jordan to be around, like, minded women that are just so ambitious and driven, and I'm so happy to be here.
This is for ILS, hashtag best newcomer, and I just feel like you portray such hard work in like trying to, you know, come into the industry like so new, and like you message me, you always ask for like, you know, support and guidance to reaching your goals within like your Lash business. And I just feel like everything you've done, even from like, you know, coming up to the Sleepover and things like that, like you're pushing yourself so much, and like honestly, like I'm just so proud of you, and I'm just so happy. Like, we're one of my students, and this one goes to Mason! Yay! No, honestly, I'm so proud of you, and I'm literally like, since she's come on the Sleepover, like, she's done like her whole logo, she's been planning everything, she's like, I've got to get everything ready for like the Sleepover. Even that alone, like, we always, like, put pressure on ourselves, and I just said to her, like, everything you've done, even the logo, she's done it herself. We know graphics ain't easy, and honestly, it's just so amazing. I'm just so proud.
I feel like this journey has made it really easy for me, because for me, new things, starting new things and change is hard. And, like, with this Sleepover, it came at the right time, so I'm happy you invited me, and it was a good opportunity, so thank you.
This ILS most improved Lash artist, and I just feel like every time like I watch your like social media or your story, like I see your sets improving, and I always say that to like all of my students or any of my students that you will see your sets improve each time. And I think as a person, an individual, like when you're actually in that moment, like you don't really feel like there is growth, especially when it comes down to creating sets. I think like lash extensions are like looked at as like an easy job or like an easy career, and it definitely is a lot harder than it looks. And for me personally, like the sets that you've like portrayed and keep portraying, like you just keeps leveling up, and I just feel like, yeah, your skill unreachable. So yeah, and this will go to Kelly. So honestly, like when I see your sets, like they're improving so much, and like you are so talented, like at what you do, and like I feel like when it comes down to skill as well, like it's so hard, because sometimes you can feel deflated, especially if you do get a client like just doesn't like your style, or like feels like, I don't know, like they've got bad retention on that particular time. It can be like deflating for like all of us. So I feel like it's important to understand your skill and your growth. And despite if you do face any difficulties, then you should always know, like, honestly, your skill is amazing, and you are only going to get better and better and better. And I'm so proud of you. No, you deserve it. So this category is to ILS most dedicated student, and I just feel like you've been with me for a while now, and I feel like, you know, recently like we've got a lot closer, like, and you've helped me out so much, and I feel like as a student, like you don't need to do a lot of the things that you do. And you know, as a like person, human, like I do really appreciate like everything that like you do for me. And yeah, I just feel like when it comes down to like you constantly improving, I feel like you from day one, like you've always like asked for feedback, and despite whether it's like constructive criticism or like, you know, maybe it's not something exactly you want to hear, you've always taken it on board, and you go away and you work on it, and you come back like 10 times better. And I feel like that's why you're where you're at
now, and yeah, thank you. No, honestly, I'm so proud of you. Like, I know it's coming up to your 2-year anniversary, and I was saying to one of the girls earlier, like, the girl come an hour and 40 minutes away the other day to come pick me up, to then go take me 4 hours to, like, near Manchester. Like, as, like, a student, you don't need to do that. Like, and you helped me out so much, like, and I feel like, you know, you see my vision and you really tried to help me build my brand, and you really believe in, like, everything that I do. And I'm just so proud of you, because that, like, even despite all of that, you're still growing, like, your business, and you're doing so amazing, and you're such an amazing person, and I'm just so proud of you.
Oh, you know what, like, I just, every time I always tell you, like, I'm always so grateful that you're, like, I came a path with you, that you taught me my whole journey, like, I learned a lot from you. I do find that we're very similar in a lot of ways, but it's like, even so, like, I still find ways to learn so much from you. It's like, I don't want to get emotional, I don't want to cry, because literally, I told you already that when it comes to this thing,
Okay guys, and last but not least, this category is for ILS star people, and I feel like, you know, you were, like, near to the, like, start of, like, my training journey, and, you know, I had a shop then, and I was doing a lot of in-person training, and I just feel like your energy and your, like, vibe and, like, just everything has just always been so amazing towards me. Like, what, like, sometimes, like, I'll just scroll through all of my students' conversations, and recently, like, I was just scrolling through our conversations, and every single thing I post up, you're always telling me, like you're always just expressing so much passion, like, you're that girl, like, you're gonna get here, you're gonna get this, you're gonna get that, like, and for me, it was just like, I was just seeing so much, and it's like, I don't even get that, like, from my own people, like, and for me, like, support means so much to me, and for someone that, like, doesn't know me, and you've just come on the Lash course, and, you know, like, your whole family know me, like, and, like, I know, like, it's just so crazy to me, and I just feel like you've always been such an amazing, like, student. You've always recommended me to people, like, my mouth, like, my name is always in your mouth, like, and not for bad reasons, and, you know, like, everything I do, everything I bring out, like, it doesn't matter what it is, it doesn't even matter if you need it or you don't need it, like, you've already got it, so yeah. This award goes to Kara. Honestly, I literally love you, and I'm so proud of you, and I feel like, you know, over these, like, years that we've, like, been together, you know, you've grown so much. Like, you've not got one business, you've not got two businesses, you've got three businesses, and you managed to juggle all of them whilst running three different social media platforms. And I feel like, again, like any advice, because I feel like at the beginning, like, I used to voice note you, like, all the time, and I feel like it got to one point, like, after a few months where, like, I don't hear from this girl no more, but this girl was voice noting me every day, and I was like, hello, is everything right? Babe, I've just been so busy. And obviously, I tell people all the time, like, at the end of the day, I encourage the support. I don't want anyone to feel like I'm too busy to not message, because I will always reply. Like, and sometimes maybe too much, to the point where the mom and dad know me. Like, and it's just like, for me, it's like, you got so busy that, you know, that you're doing everything that, you know, you wanted to do. Like, you had God knows how many jobs when you met me. Like, and now you're literally, like, this entrepreneur that's just traveling, living their life. Like, and it's just so amazing. I just can't wait to just continue
watching you grow. And no, honestly, I wouldn't be here without you as well. You've helped me through literally everything. All these phone calls, products, everything. In the worst times as well, like, even when I had my fire, Shan, see what happens. Help me without hesitation straight away. Like, there's no other Lash trainer like you.
Is everyone ready to collect their pajamas? Okay then. Okay, Shan, you're up first. Charming. Mwah! Mwah! Kara! Kaya!
Mason!
What? There's your wife!
Andy!
My
aunt. Thank you, love you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Thank you so much! Hey, hey, hey!
So guys, these are my pajamas. I don't know if you can see them. Let me try and stand over here. I'm so sorry about the state of the room. I literally have not stopped. But this is like a cute little like jacket. I had to quickly get a vest today because I forgot to pack a vest. These are my trousers. But like, I don't know if you can see, like they've got the same frills as they do on the jacket. Then I've got my little bow in. And yeah, I got all the girls like one of these bows. And yeah, I'm gonna just quickly try and tidy up a little bit because yeah, it's not giving.
Funny that it's always been all about you from the start. I met someone new last night and we kicked it. And I'm going back there tonight. And you know what's on my mind this time.
Okay guys, so everyone closes their eyes actually. But you can't cheat, okay? You can't cheat. You actually can't cheat. You actually cannot cheat. Hey, I'm nearly done. Wait, can I just take it, please? Okay, I'm nearly done. Okay, no one had time to wrap in. Yeah, we're up from the nerves, so please, yeah. Why is Karen looking around thinking, what's everyone doing? She's thinking, I didn't get one.
That's what's stupid. We got a Stanley.
So right now we're about to do girls night. We're about to do skincare, and yeah, we're all in our pajamas now. So yeah, this is the setup. This is what it's giving, and yeah, guys, my battery is about to die, so I'm gonna put it on charge and see you guys soon. Okay guys, so I'm not gonna lie, we're coming to like an end of the sleepover now. Everyone's having breakfast. We literally probably have like 4 minutes to check out, but like the girls need to eat, so I'm literally like forcing it down their necks. But yeah, I had a really good time. Girls, did you have a good time?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I can't really wrap it up properly right now because I actually have a million things to do. But yeah, I'm so grateful for everything and them and the girls and just life. And yeah, we're gonna get into that later. So yeah. Mwah!
Okay guys, so we're done, we're out, we're packed, we're ready to go. Until next time,
no bye.